Ladies and gentlemen, good evening to Hamburger Podcast. We got a great show tonight, a lot to talk about. As usual, joined by the crew that just fucking doesn't stop. Give it up for Megan Rice.
Hey, guys.
Megan's a bit sunburned and tired tonight. Yeah. Here, get a good one.
Fuck you.
Yeah. She has lobster legs.
I've been on a
legs.
Pool all day. I got real puffy eyes.
Lobster
give me
legs.
A break.
Oh, and Preston Blaine.
All right, Preston.
Give it up, huh? Mr. Ryan Talmo.
Yes, hello.
And we're joined by special guest tonight, Jem Damaggi. Do I say that right?
Damaggi. Diggity, buddy. Diggity. Jem Diggity.
Jem Diggity. Okay, Jem Diggity.
Damaggi.
I like it. I like
Jem Diggity. You can remember with the tune.
I like the way you work at.
I'm never going to do that, Jem. I'm going to tell you right now. I'm going to continue fucking women instead.
Liar.
I'm never going to listen to that song again.
Yeah, I was going to say, I used to love that song. Now I'm just going to Jem's face
great.
Just going to pop in every time.
Yeah.
You've lost some weight.
Huh?
You've lost some weight.
A little bit.
Yeah, I like that, man. Speed's been good to you.
Mm.
I don't know. Is it even called speed anymore?
I'm not a fan of speed.
Right. How old am I that I called it that?
You know, right?
What's it called now?
I don't know. Meth.
It's better than if you would have called it crank.
That's what I was thinking at first.
Meth and speed's the same?
Yeah.
Everyone blows my mind that people don't know that.
Oh, methamphetamine.
All of it's the same crap.
Yeah.
But hey, guys, just so you know, call in number is 800-893-9562. That's right. Give us a call, 800-893-9562. It's 2-for-1 tonight, so there you go. I don't know what the fuck that means.
What are we giving away, Burger?
2-for-1.
Yeah. You give us one, and we give you back two.
Bam. How you doing? You know, that's a good deal, right?
Simple.
Okay.
Simple, to the point.
So now to bring it down a little, a lot of crazy shit going on in the world.
Mm-hmm. Per usual.
Typical week.
I'm going to say it wrong, so I'm going to say it wrong, so Megan say it.
Ebola.
Thank you.
Ebola.
I keep saying Ebola. What do I say?
Ebola.
E. coli.
Ebola. Yeah, exactly.
Ebola.
Yeah. That's what I keep thinking of as E. coli. Yeah.
It's completely different.
It was a disease invented in the Swedish mountains.
Ah. wait till it mixes together. Then we'll have that famine or whatever. Death plague.
Ebola.
Well, you know what it is? It's working its way to that. I mean, like the World Health Organization. The World Health Organization just said it, they have 932 deaths. If the World Health Organization is saying that, they have 9,320 deaths. And they're telling us 932.
Oh, yeah, they're trying to keep us calm.
They're going to always jump the number way down. So we know we're in the few thousands.
And then they imported it over here to the U.S. now.
Right. Which was so not only that, they've also been importing it other places. Spain just took a person back. So they're slowly spreading it. I'm not saying Berenstain, but I'm just saying it's fucking weird shit.
But right, it is weird, but you know, 1,000 deaths in East Africa. Yeah. Isn't that like, you know, a tree falling in the forest when no one's there to hear?
That was West Africa.
Does it really
Africa.
Happen? That's an earthquake in China.
Let us at least.
Does it matter now?
You know what's funny? A lot of rich white people just went like this. Yeah, exactly.
Let us be.
And everyone else went,
what
to
is that douche
really
talking
quick.
About? Yeah.
If not politically correct, let us please be geographically correct.
It's West Africa. I forgot.
Thank you. Thank you.
No, but you didn't forget. You didn't know.
Oh, whatever.
Well, yeah.
That was the richest, whitest thing you've ever said.
When Preston dies, he's
going to
be...
But it's not only that. Saudi Arabia's got cases.
It's spread over there?
Yeah. Oh, Saudi Arabia. I mean, it's going to other places. You know, I mean, this doesn't just sit. And what people don't understand is they're saying you can't get it this way or that way. But they're not 100% sure.
Well, I think it's
direct
contact with bodily fluid. I think it's like AIDS, right?
But how much?
Bodily fluid, blood.
Bodily fluid is
like
not blood.
Sweat. No,
blood would be more direct.
Snot.
I'm saying blood. Yeah.
Blood's a guarantee.
I said that. Yeah.
Any sort of ooze?
Any sort of slimy body stuff.
Yeah.
That's why the nurses and doctors are getting it, though. And so if they can get it without it being like... Without some sort of total contact, but just being that close and touching the same things, it's going to spread. That's the, it's so stupid that this is the zombie apocalypse.
Mm.
We're going to be fine. Dustin Hoffman and Cuba Gooding Jr.
Yeah,
are going to figure out a serum.
Well, you're going to be fine because you got a private jet set up.
Renee Russo might
be
sick.
Me and Megan and Talmo and Jim are going to try and get on someone's Harley and hope to get to Arizona.
Guys, I'm blowing him. I think I might get on the plane.
He's going to dump you like a piece of shit and you know it.
I know.
Who are you blowing?
His family will heel kick your face off the ship.
Oh, Preston.
I'll blow a Harley driver though in a second.
Yeah,
that'll get me out of this place.
I'm just going to follow Bombo Belford. If anything goes down, I'm just gonna hop in his camper, like you
the
said.
The fuck you are, yeah. You know that's my plan. Don't do my fucking plan. Me and my family are showing up at Belford's fucking motorhome in North Hollywood, and we're getting the fuck. We're gonna be a half a mile, and at sometimes 14 seconds in front of the disaster, but we're gonna fucking make it.
Everybody knows.
I'm sure
where to go in the case of a disaster.
Bombo
was trying to make fucking moonshine with like WD-40 and fucking oil in his fucking thing, and then accidentally created the serum for the cure for Ebola. So
I'm telling you. I mean, this is the thing. That was who hit me to the Berenstain. And then, you know, I laughed at him, but I research everything because I laughed at him in the sense that I did, but I do take Bombo seriously. I think he's an intelligent guy.
Bombo's the dumbest smart person I know.
Yes, you know, he is very smart and nice guy, super big heart. Yeah, who gives a shit? Nobody else knows him. There's bigger things to talk about. I mean, like right now, I mean, you know, I mean, like this thing has been raised, like it's at emergency level right now. Yeah. Nothing has ever been at this level where they're saying like, hey, this is going to get fucking crazy.
No, lots of other things have been at this
level.
Spanish influenza.
Well, that wasn't
20
bad.
Million people.
Fuck! Yeah.
Megan, whatever.
More
that I'm
than
wrong.
Killed everyone in World War One.
Guys, he's a teacher.
Yeah,
that's
Spanish.
Why people hate bitches.
What about
the Spanish
SARS.
Flu is really bad.
Can I ask a question real quick? Can we get back to Talmo saying what was the Spanish? I said what about SARS?
That's what I said.
I thought you said what about the Spanish flu?
SARS, you just need chicken soup and 7-Up. That was the good old joke of that one.
Mm-hmm.
That's all you need for SARS.
Oh, I'm sorry. What I meant to say was the highest state of alert that they have. That's all it is.
Right, but
it's
SARS,
at the highest state.
SARS, they had...
SARS only hurt Asian people, and there's so goddamn many.
SARS, they had a cure for SARS. This Ebola thing, they don't really know. Like, the guy who brought down to Atlanta, they weren't sure if they were going to be able to fix him. Apparently, they did.
No, well, he's feeling better or something.
Yeah,
right.
So
yeah, we don't know if he's
He could still be contagious. They don't know if he's contagious.
What's the equivalent of HIV for Ebola? Like, you don't have AIDS yet, but you have
it's Ebola.
HIV is what you're talking about.
You have E. coli,
AIDS is the
but
full
you'll
blow.
Soon have Ebola.
He has Ebola, but not Ebola.
And then after Ebola, you have Ebola. So
It works its way around.
Yeah.
And
then you're
fucked.
Screwed.
Now that picture you post on Facebook with that child with all
that
the bumps.
That was a child
that's
Ebola.
What you look like when you get Ebola.
Well,
okay.
It's like
different
the black
things,
plague, basically.
And they have to burn you. I mean, that's how contagious it is.
Yeah, it's the black plague.
Yeah.
So they burn the body.
But that's what I'm saying. These people are developing boils. Okay, well, what people don't understand is, to make a weird analogy, where I live, there's what they call ghetto ants. And these ants, you could spray Raid in their fucking face, and they'll just open up.
Yeah.
Like, they're getting, like, some Xanax rush off it, you know? Like, they don't give
faster.
A shit.
They
get don't
stronger.
Die.
They grow twice as big.
I'm telling you right now.
Raid is speed for ants.
When they told me, I laughed until I tried, and they did not die. And you were like, whoa. But just the same way, these people will not, after a while, they won't die. They'll just be infected, and the infection itself will eat away at their body, their brain, their, you know, nervous system. And that's kind of the zombie apocalypse that everyone talks about. It probably won't happen, but that kind is it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But what's not going to happen is the United States, who apparently has a cure, isn't going to send a bunch of serum over to Africa.
Right?
That's what's not going to happen.
Because it'll get weaponized. Exactly.
Well, it's a lot of money.
Yeah.
Why would they just send for those two people? Why wouldn't they just keep them there in the quarantine?
And burn them.
And just not. I feel bad. I feel bad.
They were American doctors, so they brought them home.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so you shoot them.
They were doctors. If they were just American citizens, I'm sure they would. If they were us, they would have just kept us. They would have been like, thank God.
Yeah, if it was two comics, they wouldn't have shipped us home.
They'd been like, thank God.
On a West Africa tour.
No, actually, if it was two comics, they'd been like, okay, do a set at the Comedy Store, infect every other comic with Ebola.
And then we'll just lock the doors.
Yeah.
It's a Tommy move, guys. It's
right?
a Tommy
move.
Take out the entire comic community in one blow.
He comes back like the Phantom of the Opera, but he's like the Phantom of Ebola. And he just spreads it. And he's like, here it is.
He takes off his mask and there's fucking boils on his face.
Has anybody talked to Tommy recently?
Yeah. Yeah, the other day I saw him and he was like, "Hi, welcome to Fatburger."
it's a joke. I get it. Okay. I understand. No, but seriously, I'm worried. I would hope that Tommy's okay.
Why?
Because he was fun. Look how many people make do the imitation of Tommy.
You know who was a great actor and actually a theater person? Hitler. A lot of people went.
He was not a theater person. Hitler was a failed artist.
He was a failed artist.
Theater.
You don't know if he went to the fucking theater, Jim.
He had to be trained how to be theatrical, like he turned into later. Okay,
that's the speed talking, Jim.
The Holocaust.
They did use a lot of speed, though.
The Holocaust was a modern art institution. No one got it.
Didn't he build a time machine just to go back in time?
That's what we changed the name to the Berenstain Bears. Yeah.
That's what Chuck.
Can we please, Christ, not get back into that?
Don't get me started.
We have a lot of stuff I'd rather talk about tonight.
Wake the fuck up. Okay.
Oh my God.
Speaking of which, let's talk about, you know, like right now, you know, Obama is, right now they're dropping food for the Christian people in Iraq.
Followed by bombs.
Okay, well, but then they're going to be.
Followed
by
food bombs.
They're going to be dropping, they're talking about he's going to okay airstrikes on the Islamic people.
ISIS people.
And yeah, and here's the thing. I'm a Jew. I'm Jewish.
I'm a Jew.
Jew. I am Jewish. And the fact is, it's like this. If you think about it, what the Islamic group is doing there is they're saying, like, this was our land.
Yeah.
You're going to get the fuck out, and we're taking it back. And in fact, historically, it was Muslim or Islamic land prior to the Christians being there, and they came in and took it. Now, same thing with the Israelis. Yeah, we know the Palestinians were monsters in the beginning.
Yeah.
And the Israelis stood up and our people took our country back. But at this point, the U.S. is saying, hey, we're going to go in there and we're going to bomb these Islamic people. And we're going to back the Israelis who are doing the same fucking thing. And it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
What's that?
It doesn't make sense that we're okay with backing Israel to bomb Palestinians beyond the fact of when they were the monsters. Okay, I get our country wanting to defend itself and stay as Israel. It's just at the same time, what you're doing is sort of a genocide.
What Israel is doing?
What Israel is doing to Palestine, in a sense, is a sort of attempted genocide. And
I mean,
the Gaza Strip
is basically a giant internment camp that they fire fucking rockets into.
So that's what I'm saying.
They fire rockets from there?
But the U.S. backs Israel, but they're going to go bomb Islamic people who want their land back the same way as Israel.
Why can't the people in the Middle East be like the Native Americans, just be content with their casinos and alcoholism?
I can't disagree with you.
Once white people take their land.
I can't disagree with
you. Can't they all be that?
Did
just
you say
like
the Palestinians
that?
And the they're the same, the Jews and the Palestinians. They got the Israelis.
Were until fucking religion happened. And then they separated. Now they bomb each other.
That's what people don't understand. People are talking about you have to eradicate Hamas. And I'm like, which Hamas person? Yeah. All of them? Because some of them are bad people, probably.
They just live in that place.
Yeah.
They have no choice.
Yeah.
It's where they're raised.
Terrorism is based on hatred for people that aren't like you. You're not going to eradicate hatred from fucking human consciousness. People fucking hate each other for whatever stupid fucking reason. And they're going to get in wars because of it. Like, you can't just say, okay, we bombed 6 schools and then Hamas is going to go away. No, that's never going to happen.
Well, I'll tell you this, is one of the things I always say about terrorism, that it's kind of bullshit. In the sense that if if like the Taliban or Al-Qaeda and all these people wanted to really create terrorism, couldn't you just send people out on suicide missions onto the freeway, different freeways throughout cities,
well, to just kamikazes.
to just machine gun people in cars, right? How many of us are going to go
Stop
out in our fucking
cars? Stop giving
ideas. No, I can't be the only person who ever thought of this.
No, I know. The DC sniper, remember? They closed malls in Virginia for like 3 weeks.
Wasn't it a kid, though?
It was a grown man, his son was like 17.
No, it wasn't his son, but
or
they
his
were
uncle or something.
He was
maybe
a guy and a boy, and he was having him snipe out of the back thing, and he was sniping. But here was the thing. If the terrorists really wanted to terrorize America, couldn't they just blow themselves up in malls?
Or a sporting event or
anything?
A mall, yeah.
So if terrorism was real, wouldn't that be going on? Because I would stop going fucking pretty much everywhere. You know?
Right. No. Yeah, I know.
They could shut down our economy by doing that.
But they do that in every other country.
Yeah.
Well, apparently, like supposedly, yes, but that's what I'm saying is why aren't they doing this if they're really terrorists?
In this country?
And my true belief is that terrorism is a money game.
Oh, it's
all about creating a need for, a want for, and generating the income flowing back and forth between people. That's all it has to do with. It doesn't have to do with real people being upset. The people who were Palestinian and were blowing themselves up in the very beginning, they were real. They were fed up. Like, that was real.
Right,
yeah.
But after that, all of a sudden, people were getting paid to do it.
Your families are taken care of as you can...
At some point, when you're having trouble recruiting people to say, "Hey, go kill yourself in this fucking in this mall or whatever, or this fucking and what are they doing? You know, killing, strapping a bomb on their chest and fucking Baghdad.
Going to coffee shops in Israel,
Coffee shops in Israel or whatever, or like in Northern Ireland.
At some point, they
can't recruit enough people because like I'm not gonna fucking kill myself for this bullshit. And they're like, okay, well, you live in an incredibly poor country. Here's what's going to happen. I'm going to give your family money after you die. And you're like, well, I don't have a job anyway. So, okay, I'll kill myself if my family can get 12 grand.
Yeah, but then you found out it wasn't that the terrorists were paying them. It was that they were getting paid, but they didn't really ever prove that it was terrorists paying them. So that's what I'm saying is like, I don't know for sure, but I'm saying like if the U.S. was paying them to go do this stuff, to continue this thing, to keep it going... Because Bush Jr. was just a puppet. Love that guy though. Who ducks a shoe? And so
that was a pretty good.
That was the greatest. That's when I loved him.
You can say a lot of bad shit about W, but goddamn it, he's got good reflexes.
You won me over when you ducked two shoes.
As you could tell whenever you threw a ball out at a baseball game.
Yeah,
he has some good reflexes.
Yeah, no.
You know why Bush was so fucking arrogant? He wanted to look so good. Throwing a pitch out. He's like the only person. He would go into the batting cages in the clubhouse and warm up his arm and start throwing pitches so he wouldn't make an ass out of himself in front of everybody, which is a good move.
Yeah.
He's a good old boy.
Well, wait a second. He was part owner of the Texas Rangers, so he's a big baseball fan his whole life. So,
I know.
So you can't really blame him for wanting to go in the dugout.
I'm not saying that. Yeah. I'm saying that's the only good thing he ever did was throw out fucking pitches.
Bush Jr. is the guy you want to hang out with, you want to party with. He's a good guy. His dad made him do the president
thing. Well, he doesn't drink anymore. In the 70s, fuck yeah. But
even now, he's still got some blow in his nose, but that's the whole thing is, what's funny is the whole campaign that Obama ran on was no more troops in Iraq. And now we're going back.
Very exciting.
Honestly,
maybe Russia,
which is scary. I think the next step is just there's going to be fucking.
Oh, it's
drone bombing raids in every fucking country in the Middle East for the next 30 years.
World War III times four.
We're not going to send any troops to the ground unless some really bad shit goes down, but we're going to keep fucking bombing hospitals and schools.
Well, I mean, it's like Megan was talking about, it was bringing up Russia earlier.
Yeah.
I mean, go for it because you know more about it than me.
Oh, what about the sanctions?
The sanctions, the identity theft, the food, everything.
Well, I mean, okay. Well, Preston can go into the ridiculous. I mean, they stole a bunch of passwords and stuff, like a lot.
A bunch.
I mean, a bunch of money.
Almost like a billion, right?
1.2 billion unique usernames and passwords.
But it's like, it's like they already figured out most, it's going to be used for spam shit. Like, they're not stealing identities from, like...
Damn it.
It's right, which
they're
not
even doing
happen.
It for a good reason. They're
it's
doing
not
it
for a
bullshit
good reason.
Reason to send you fucking weight loss
And my favorite was like Fox
Facebook.
News was like, oh, is the Russian government involved? Like, not on Fox. I don't mean to say Fox News. Just news in general. Like, some news outlets were saying like, oh, maybe this has something to do with Jem, really?
I was trying to find some information about what we were talking about. I didn't realize the volume was up on my phone. I apologize.
Try to keep it going. You're a pro.
Jen just threw me up. No, don't but I mean, it's just, yeah. Like some news organizations were talking about like, oh, maybe the Russian government's involved. And it's like, shut the fuck up. This is like a house full of Russian hackers that are probably 16 years old.
A bunch of kids.
And they're going to sell it to spammers and they're going to get a very tiny amount of money for it.
Russians are hardcore fucking people, though. Yeah. At the same time, you know.
Well, they're the last of the Vikings.
Well, you know what it is everyone talks about it in Russia. Oh, it's like so hard. It's so horrible. For who? Not the people living the good life?
90% of the population, it's terrible. Eh,
but how about, okay, how about 90 fucking percent? They say the 1%, so 99% here? You know, in that, in their figures.
Yeah, but there's, what, 30% of the population in this country is living below the poverty line. So I would say 30% of the people in this country have really shitty lives.
More than now.
But the rest of the 70% have fine lives.
Oh, it's all in perspective.
Yeah.
It's all on perspective.
No, I agree.
Well, it's all in perspective, of course.
Life isn't shitty just because of money.
Right. Exactly. Yes. But also,
I know. But
if you can't afford food for 3 days, life's a little shittier.
Not knowing if you're going
to
be able to
food bank.
Not knowing if you're going
to
be able to eat.
Oh, all the big, all the great food banks in Russia?
Oh, this isn't the best.
You're talking about Russia. Well, Russia's even easier. You just got to suck some cock to get some food.
You know what it is?
I mean,
we're going back and forth from here in Russia.
No, you know what it is, though? If we talk about Russia, this is the bullshit of America, and it's that America will tell you how horrible everywhere else is, and everywhere else will tell you how horrible fucking America is.
Yeah.
You think when they show L.A., they show the middle of Beverly Hills? No, they show
fucking
South
Central.
Yes,
actually they do, and that's why they don't like it.
Well, they show like this. They either show the richest people or the poorest
people.
Well,
yeah.
They don't show the tons in between.
Well, that's what people find interesting.
Right.
People don't find people that have, you know, that someone who's living in... the Midwest, who's working a 9-to-5 at a medical supply company and goes home to their 3 kids.
Yeah.
And they're scraping by, not great, but they're eating every day. Mm-hmm. And they go out to dinner once a week.
Yeah.
And they go on vacation every 3 years.
Them.
Nobody cares about that. That's
and they're
not
in
interesting.
Russia, too, though. They are in Russia, too.
No, exactly.
Too. And, you know, people always say, like, oh, we have a middle class. No one else does. Really? No one else has a middle class? Because that's stupid. Statistically, you have to have a fucking middle class because nobody is
developed.
Just poor.
Developed countries have a middle class.
But even no, you can go to Haiti, and that was the bullshit that came out during their disaster when they were talking about all the hotels and all the resorts that got ruined. Really? Because I thought everyone ate fucking mud pies. That's what they were telling us forever.
Yeah.
Everyone in Haiti ate mud pies. But we found out there were resorts and people living in homes.
Well, there's resorts in any nice country.
With track homes.
With good tropical weather.
Residential neighborhoods. Yeah. But we were told for so long they were eating mud pies.
Well, the ice cream tree, right?
And 98% of the people were, though.
That's exactly.
No, but that's the thing.
Just because some people are, you know, lording it over the rest of them, you know, doesn't mean that we shouldn't feel sorry for the ones that are being lorded over.
Yeah.
Totally. But look at this country. We're in the same boat. That's the illusion.
What do you mean?
What are you talking about?
Let me ask you a question. Yeah. Do you think that in Haiti right now they have, like, the handheld devices
Wi-Fi.
That we have, Wi-Fi.
Yeah, they do. I don't think they do.
I think everywhere. I think some of the rich people have it, but everyone here in the United States has it.
Not really.
What are you talking about? Don't you have a smartphone?
I know people that don't even have a phone.
And
so.
Here's the thing.
But the Talmo in most countries.
No, but here's
the Talmo who makes sandwiches in other countries doesn't have a fucking smartphone.
In Taiwan and China and Mexico and all these places and all these countries, they have all this technology. They just pay a hell of a lot less for it. But they have the same technology we have. And that's the illusion that we're this free country and the rest of the world is so captive. And we're not. If you've been to Europe, they're so much freer than us.
Well, no, there's always that right-wing perspective of, oh, go to Europe, they're fucking communists. You know, every country but America is bullshit. Yeah, tell me, try to argue that fucking England and France isn't free. That's the dumbest fucking argument.
Right.
Of course they are. It's
no
fucking
one
retarded.
Argues that. Nobody
Sweden,
argues
Holland.
That.
Yeah, they do. People on the...
Venezuela yes. even, and they got that
of,
dictator.
Plenty of right-wingers think that that's the case.
Everyone thinks
or
Cuba...
They don't think it's the case, but they say it's the case, so the fucking retards that listen to their radio show believe it.
Well, if you look at Cuba, if you look at Cuba, everyone talks, oh, Cuba's this horrible place. Not for the people who dig it, and that's a lot of people there who dig it.
Yeah, the people you know? That leave it are the ones that only have family in America, and they're the ones that are just leaving because they want to be... That's just...
They're told some bullshit that this is the opportunity, and they're going to come here and live in shitholes forever until their family eventually evolves into having money.
By the way, with Europe... minus England and a few other countries, they're all under the euro, and the euro is like fucked.
Yeah, the EU.
Yeah,
it's like seriously fucked. So I don't know how their class is dealing because that's like one big class in a way.
It'll be all right once the computers take over,
right?
No, it'll be okay. There'll be a small segment of the human population that'll be allowed to live, and the rest of us will be wiped out. You know, if you've ever yelled at your Siri app, you're in trouble.
I don't have a Siri. So,
you don't have
no,
some
the
kind
scary
of
thing, and I hate being like a pessimist, but the word Elysium might happen at some point in the next 100 years.
Yeah. We won't be alive though.
No, I don't even think 100 years.
So who cares?
Your
I don't think 100 years.
But the singularity is going to hit, Talmo, and we're all going to put our brains into fucking Terminator robots, and we'll be brain, but then we'll have robot bodies.
I'm living to be 146, Ryan. Don't forget that.
We'll be still
you're going to look rough, Tammy. You are going to look rough at 146.
I know. No. Yeah, but it'll be okay. It'll be okay once I'm 123.
We're all going to look rough at 146.
Jim, you'll get skin grafts to tighten it up a bit.
Once I'm 123.
How old are you right now?
Stop stepping on my premise. Once I'm 123, I'm going to become a heroin addict. So,
again?
So that'll get you through the final 45 years.
Well, no, I figure
I'm
going
to do you know math? He said he's going to live to 146. He said 123.
So
and
I
you
figure,
said the final 40 years?
He said like 68.
So I figure I'm going to still want those 18-year-old junkie chicks to be playing with my dick.
Okay.
So I'll give them something to do.
See,
they
when
can
you
inject
first
the heroin
started your premise,
penis.
I thought it was a bunch of bullshit, but now 18-year-old junkie chicks, now
you
I'm into it.
I'm with you.
Preston's
I'm with
on
you.
Board.
How old are, can, do you say how old you are?
Sure, I'll be 45 in a few days.
Oh, hell yeah. I'll be 45 in November.
Nice.
I like that. Yeah, no, I hate people who go, I don't say my
age. We were in the same grade.
Well, you know what it is? I hate people who go like, oh, I don't say
so
my
So you graduated
age.
In 87?
I would have, yeah. I was originally an eighth grade dropout.
Yeah.
I did my GED. Then
I'm
I
down.
Got my,
GED,
I,
but college.
Then I went to college and got my degree. And
did you go to prison at all?
No.
Oh, I did.
Say.
I'm just saying. I got multiple degrees. I got the prison degree and the college degree.
Nice.
Yeah. I'm
what
lying.
Prison were you
I'm
at?
Lying.
Okay,
I
was
going to
call
college.
You out on it, though. Yeah.
No. I went to prison.
What prison?
I didn't graduate college.
What
I went
prison
for 7 years. But
what prison
you're
were
prison
you
prison for 7 years?
No, I was in college for 7 years.
What prison did you go to?
I really liked college.
What prison did you go to?
You liked college better than prison.
Wait.
I was in prison in England.
That's not prison.
How are the English prisons? Nice.
Well,
it's
they treat
totally
you
good.
They treat you like a human being
you
and make sure you have tea every day.
Every day,
they don't
crumpets.
Give you a biscuit. You know,
no biscuits with the tea.
They do
what a bunch of fucking animals! They don't even give you a biscuit to dunk in the tea. They
do like to play a game called Soggy Biscuit.
Yeah. Oh, that
God.
Sounds
is
good.
That like, is that like limp biscuit?
What were you? You were actually. You know what's funny? Wait, because it's coming back to me. You were in prison in England.
I was.
Yeah, there was a whole thing about that.
For methylene dioxymethylamphetamine for 35 months.
Yeah, there we go. I knew. Okay.
MDMA?
And, yeah.
MDMA, commonly referred to as ecstasy.
Right?
When was
how are you
this?
Doing?
When was this?
Huh? I love that people need things to get horny. I just
it doesn't
need
get
vagina.
You horny.
I need how a vagina.
It?
I'm horny.
It doesn't get you horny.
What does it do?
It makes you capable of love.
I'm capable. I'm fucking capable.
Because otherwise... God knows you can't be.
Yeah,
that's
what
in
I never
this day
get.
And age, oh yeah,
that's what I never get.
Well, you're trained not to love.
I love
in this society.
No,
you're trained,
I love.
No, that's lust. You're trained
okay,
not
here's,
to love.
Wrong. Here's my question: how are the drug laws over there? So, same thing happened in the States. What would you be looking at time wise? I would assume more.
No,
or not.
I mean,
35 months.
They're more lenient over there.
That's like 2 years.
35 months is 3 years.
Yeah,
three
that's
years,
basically
3 years.
36 would
yeah,
be, yeah.
Very good. Good on the
right,
math.
Right, but wouldn't MDMA over here be like 7? Or maybe not. I don't know.
Well, it all
I mean,
varies.
Depends on your lawyer.
It depends
Let's
on
give it a
the
shot.
Amount.
Jim, do it again.
It all varies.
Who's your family? Yeah.
Like in California, my friend got busted with 99 plants, very big plants of cannabis growing, and he got 18-month wobbler.
So right, he doesn't get in trouble for 18 months.
So yeah, light on weed. I mean,
in
that's
Oklahoma,
weed in
he
California.
Would have been sentenced to 250 years.
Texas life.
Yeah.
So the difference between England and here, you know, you should look at the difference
states,
between Oklahoma
the different
and here.
States, yeah.
Hey, guys, call in number 800-893-9562. Call in if you got some opinion on this. We're talking weed. We're talking Iraq strike.
Texas has
all kinds
executed.
Of stuff, yeah.
Yeah, life,
you know, yeah, that's what we do.
Robots.
You know what? You know what? I want to jump into
some pussy.
No. Okay. Yes.
I got Ryan to laugh. I was expecting Megan to laugh too, but
wait,
it didn't
let me
happen.
Say, let me say yes.
Jump in feet first to some pussy.
Yeah. But
that is the best way to get into
well, no,
it.
Well, no. See, this is the weird thing because it's going to be a weird segue now. I can't fucking do the segue because you made it all chauvinistic, and now I'm going to talk about.
No, I think that was misogynistic, actually.
Have you ever seen the name of the show?
Skid Row Studios?
No, motherfucker. I'm Burger Podcast. Don't correct me. So here's the thing. Okay. So here's the thing. One of the best things, I love this because I am somebody who is completely pro equal rights for everybody. I don't give a shit who.
What about pedophiles?
Equal. Them too.
Rapists.
I think they should equally
like
be able to be killed.
Serial
we
killers.
We should equally kill every one of them.
We should have a purge.
Yeah.
We should have like a little purge.
Let's
like
get into this. Is a great. This is a great moment in America right now. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to let Preston take this over because he knows about sports.
What are we? Oh, yeah. The San Antonio Spurs hired a female assistant coach, former WNBA player. She's been in
really
WNBA
cool.
for like 6 years. And
how
I'm
long
just,
before she quits from sexual harassment?
Nah,
what do you think?
No, they're not going to do that.
I mean, I think, Greg, how the Spurs have a lot of veterans. Greg Popovich has been their coach for 20 years. I don't think it's going to be a problem, but I can't wait to hear Tony Dungy come out and say that he doesn't agree with her lifestyle choices and she shouldn't be a coach.
Nah. Right?
Yeah, because he said that about the gay guy.
Well, some crazy thing is going to happen.
Wait,
where someone's going to bring up the C word, whether it be coaching or something, you know.
Is he really conservative?
Cheese?
He said
somebody's going to bring up the word
right?
cheese.
He said he wouldn't have drafted Michael Sam because it would have been a distraction.
Yeah.
And when the... When Jason Collins came out, the NBA player, he said, yeah, he should be able to play basketball, but I don't agree with his lifestyle choices.
But he
because Tony Dungy chose to be black, just like how they chose to be gay.
That's what he meant. Yeah, it wasn't his fault.
Yeah, of course.
He was
not.
Like, they said, hey, what do you want to be? He thought, black.
Right. It seems easy.
He didn't know.
It seems way easier than rich and white.
It just seemed like a cool color.
I would have picked black.
Yeah. When you're not really born yet, it seems like a cool fucking color.
Yeah.
It's an abstract.
Black makes
everything
you look
else
thinner.
Is a color. Yeah. Man. Yeah, right? You think things like that and you don't realize that, oh, I'm going to be thinner because I can't get a job to eat.
Yeah.
You know, but still thinner.
Yeah. What are you talking about? What country can people not eat? In the United States, it's so easy to get food. It's so easy to get food. It might be GMO food. They save all the good organic greens for everyone else, okay?
That's the thing.
I live on Skid Row. I mean, I live like two blocks from here, you know? So, I mean, I know.
You have a cot in this studio.
No,
this is Jim's house.
He doesn't have a cot yet. He's working his way up to a
Jim's
cot.
Jim's got a big
he's
day tomorrow.
He's got to get to bed.
I thought you were house-sitting for Leslie.
I have not been house-sitting at Leslie's for... 3 months now.
I'm a little behind the time.
3 months. It's been three months.
Back.
Yeah, it's all good. A lot of things have happened. I mean, Tommy no longer works at the Comedy Store. I don't house sit for Leslie. I mean, lots
those
of
those are the
stuff.
Only two things that have happened in 3 months.
Coco came back to the Comedy Store last night
for
the first time in 7 years.
Who did?
Coco.
Coco. Joey Coco Diaz?
Yeah.
Oh, that guy's fantastic.
Who the fuck is Coco?
Joey Coco Diaz.
Coco, baby.
Phenomenal comic.
But wait a minute. Isn't he trying to get away from the nickname?
No. I can't see him doing that. No, he's so great.
He's always at the Laugh Factory.
Yeah,
isn't he?
He's never stepped in the beast of a comic.
That's exactly how they described him on the thing was beast.
He is
just a beast.
Beast of a comic.
No, he's great. He's great.
Yeah, no, definitely someone I just enjoy watching.
So wait, if Tommy gone, is all the bans being lifted?
Well, they're being
bands.
Re-looked at. All the comics that were banned 86 from the venue.
I don't know who is banned.
Isn't Dane Cook banned?
No, not from Tommy. I don't think Tommy really banned anyone.
Okay. Yeah,
Tommy
I think he didn't really want people there. There were certain people, I think, that that's what it was.
What were you saying, Preston?
And certain people that didn't want to come back.
Hey, yeah, there's probably certain people you don't want to come back.
Let me say this.
Like Dane Cook, whatever you think about his comedy, he's a fucking name. Why would you ban him from the comedy club?
He's
going to bring people in.
They didn't ban him. I saw Dane Cook go up there when he wanted to.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I'll say this about Tommy is Tommy used to give me two spots, which would be a Saturday main room spot and a weekday spot every week. And I would get a hosting spot, whether it be Sunday or Monday, doing the potluck every week. So I don't hate him.
Until you had the battle with Paulie.
No, not even that. I just never called back in.
Because you got mad about Paulie, how he acted.
Well, I just, you know what it is?
I was there that night.
Yeah,
I saw that.
I don't like little bitches, you know? And it's like, and yeah, I get it. I shouldn't have probably brought him up as some asshole who's never said hi to me and blah, blah, blah. But at the same time, he hasn't.
Oh.
That's the thing. Paulie doesn't like poor people. Paulie doesn't like working class. He wants to be an elitist. But you know what? You should say hi to people.
But he was raised that way.
I think he just doesn't talk to people that have penises.
Well, I mean, he was raised as, like, you know, silver spoon, total platinum
spoon. Well, see, and I know deep shit about him. Like, I know shit that he's done deep in L.A. because I grew up my whole life in L.A. Mm. And, you know, and so the thing is, it's just whatever. But so with Tommy, he was always helpful to me. It's just he wasn't helpful to comedy.
Well, a lot of people left
because
they just wouldn't come back.
Well, yeah, exactly. That's what I mean. But like, I don't think there were bans, but I think there were. I think there was people that didn't want to come back, and there was people he didn't want to come back.
Yeah, and like I don't think he banned Rogan.
People just decided to do that.
Yeah, like Tommy didn't ban Rogan, which was the Comedy Store's worst choice ever. To ban Rogan, because not only is the dude absolutely hysterical, but he's one of the most popular comics that does actual
drugs,
his own material,
he does lots of drugs. He's great.
Drugs and his
own. What's great about him is he came to drugs later.
He used to walk around with a bag of fucking edibles.
So he was sober for a long ass time, and then he was like, "Oh, I've been so stupid." It was like an awakening. Duh. Like God came to him in the form of cannabis and DMT.
It allowed him to stop bullying people. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, he's a fucking hysterical comic. But he used to walk around with bags of edibles. You know, but I mean, just such a funny comic. And they banned him over Mencia. That was a horrible choice.
It's going to be interesting to see if he goes back.
But Mencia hasn't been back since that happened, right?
No, he has.
Did he?
Yeah, really? Yeah. But see, that was the thing is he would walk out. He would come in and all the comics would walk out and other comics would refuse to go up.
And yeah, because they didn't want to go up when he was in the room because it's like, okay, what's going to happen in 6 months? I'm going to hear my joke on fucking Carlos Mencia's Comedy Central special.
Which would happen anyway at the Comedy Store, which is a fucking shame. Which is, it's filled with a bunch of hack fucking joke stealing pieces of shit. And that was why I went off the way I did. And that's why I haven't called in. But I might call in now because hopefully it's going to change. And I don't know, maybe they won't even put me up. You never know, you know, but I might call in again because there's a good change. And Adam Egbert.
Yeah, but isn't
Adam
having your name on the wall sort of like a ticket?
Well, it just depends. You know how much you piss people off. I mean, if you piss off the fucking owner's son, you know.
Well.
And I ran into him at a coffee bean with Kurt Fox, and then I went off on him there, too. And someone videoed it and put it on some gossip sites,
wait till Benji's dad buys the Comedy Store.
Benji Aflalo?
Yeah. You should just wait for that to happen. I'm just saying, you should just wait for that to happen and then call in. And you'll probably get like 5 days in a row. Bam, bam, bam.
You know what? I like Benji. And Benji, we like each other for the same reason. I'm really grew up poor. Benji really is grown up rich and he doesn't deny it. And that's what I like about him. He always is straightforward with it. Anyway, we got more shit to talk about. What was our next thing, Megan? You're always on this. Oh, cunt of the week.
Cunt of the week. Okay, this week's a pretty good one. So, we all know what fracking is, right? If you don't know, fracking is a way to extract natural gas from the earth. And they drill down, and then they shoot a bunch of water laced with chemicals that helps break apart the rock. And then the natural gas starts seeping up through these pipes, and then they collect the natural gas. Well, there's loads of chemicals in this in the fracking water. And one of the things that Dick Cheney had passed before he went out of office was that they can the EPA can never ask what chemicals are in the fracking liquid that they shoot down in there. Uh-huh. And they can never, you know, they're never going to question it, whatever the fracking companies do. Now we know it's poisonous. So this guy in Ohio, Benedict Lupo, what a fucking cunt name, by the way.
Benedict. I mean, there you
Lupo.
Go. You're a second for Benedict Arnold.
I like Benedict Cumberbatch. He's good.
Yeah, but whatever. Fine. Yeah, fine. He's a good actor. Whatever. Anyway.
Benedict
Cumberbatch.
Is that an actor?
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway, Benedict Lupo, he's the cunt of the week. He owns a fracking company in Ohio. And he was told, obviously, that he has to properly dispose of this fracking liquid.
Yeah.
And he didn't, because he saved money by dumping it into the water supply. And it killed this Ohio creek, and now he's actually serving, what's he doing? 28 months in jail, which actually, as much of a cunt he is.
28 fucking months? That's it?
That's not enough.
7 months less than I did.
But isn't that
exactly
for some shit that everybody wanted?
But wait a minute.
Yeah, right?
It was good as fuck.
Hold on.
Didn't poison anyone. Didn't poison anyone.
But wait a minute.
People fucked.
I know. And
they came down, because it's not really good to fuck on ecstasy.
He should have gotten more time, because this fracking liquid, it poisons the water supply and people get sick all the time, and their fucking water, you can light their water on fire and all this shit.
Yeah.
But God damn it, he actually went to fucking jail, and he was the boss of this company. Like, finally, like, is this, hopefully this is a push in the right direction where fucking douchebag millionaires that knowingly do something to hurt other people.
He went for 2 years.
To save money. Right, but it's better than a fucking fine.
Well, yes, no, agreed.
At least they didn't fine him $100,000 and say keep fracking in Ohio.
How about the people
who
died?
At least
he's
going to fucking jail.
No, it's
true. As opposed to like bankers and the people from GM who fucking let bullshit cars that they know
for 15 years
stall on the highway. Yeah,
right. No, I got you.
No one's going to go to jail.
What about the people who died? I mean, it's not based on what GM did. They should fucking be killed too. The people who knew. I mean, that's the thing. People died.
Right, but maybe we'll see this and say, okay, it's now we can finally start making these people accountable.
It's all the water in Toledo, right? Toledo, yeah. Ohio. It's like none of it's drinkable. Like, you cannot touch it.
Right.
And so they're drinking out of, like, water bottles. Or, like, are they taking showers out of the...
No. You can take showers in it, but you can't ingest it.
Or else
it'll make you sick.
Yeah. I mean, they have videos of people with fracking. Like, you can turn your tap on and people will put a flame in their tap.
Fire.
And their tap water lights on fire.
Is it on YouTube?
Because there's
methane. You can look it up on YouTube, seriously. Yeah.
Oh, no, watch Gasland 1 and Gasland 2 are two HBO documentaries about fracking. All in Pennsylvania. And they're doing it everywhere. They do it in fucking Baldwin Hills.
Yeah, in Baldwin
Hills.
What
about the snow that catches fire?
Well,
they have snow.
Well, shit, what was the Cuyahoga River caught on fire like 7 times in the 80s?
It's the chemtrails. That's what, I mean, this is the thing. This is what people don't get. I'm not saying our government's doing it to us. They're just spraying chemicals.
Yeah.
Whatever they're doing, they're spraying chemicals. If it's to protect us, if it's to hurt us, I don't know.
But as bad as this shit was, I'm thinking I might see a silver lining in it.
Where?
In the guy. He actually fucking went to jail. So maybe
but for
people
how long?
It was only 28 months, but maybe
how much did he make a year? Probably
he's
guess.
A fucking millionaire. He's
You're
a fracker.
Rich.
More than
so for 28
more than
months,
$28 million.
The guy owns a fracking company.
And
he's probably worth $50 million.
His books were full.
You think he's going to the same jail as me?
He had all of the stuff that he wanted, and when he was inside, all the little snacks and
food,
and he had, I'm sure he had a TV.
Wait, his own TV. Yeah. He had direct
TV. I almost got in a fight over my Colorados I was wearing. This is going back 20 years or so when I went to jail. My Colorado boots. I almost had to fight over that shit. I almost had to fight over a fucking blanket.
Yeah.
Okay, you think he's dealing with any of that? He's got, like, he's trying to figure out. Okay,
this is in county?
Yeah,
no,
he's trying to figure out.
How long are you in county?
Oh, I was just there like a week or two.
Like a couple weeks?
Yeah. Yeah.
He's not, but a rich guy being away from his yacht for 28 months hopefully is enough of a deterrent where he doesn't fucking do it again.
No, why would he?
Of course he's going to do it again.
He'll still be rich.
It's not a deterrent. If it's just hopefully the next guy who's gonna do this goes, I don't want to go to jail for 2.5 years. Yeah. That's right. The only thing you could hope for is the silver lining. This guy's not gonna change his fucking act because he got 2 years.
Hopefully he won't be able to frack again. Hopefully
you know what it is? You know what the simple thing is, if you really think about it, is the world has hit a point where there's no low. I was saying the other day is I've been looking everywhere to try and run into the person who's like, yeah, it gets no worse than me. You know, but that would just be a puddle of disease with lips.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Like you can't find that. It's just the world has gotten to a point where it's just shit. You can't trust anyone. You don't know who you're talking to. You know what? A great story that just came out was, Oklahoma. 49-year-old female teacher shows up to work.
What'd she do, her job well?
First day.
Drunk.
Didn't even get to do her job. It's the first day of school. She shows up drunk on vodka, which nice. I love. I love vodka, but not for school. Drunk on vodka and apparently ends up taking off her pants.
Nice.
This is a public school teacher. Okay, she shows up on Monday.
My thing is she was like 22, fresh out of college, and it was like her first thing. She's like, I'm real nervous. No. I need to take a couple of drinks before I go to my very first day teaching.
Yeah, 49 years old.
This woman has been doing this her entire life.
What course
she told
was she
them.
Teaching?
She told the police. She was all like, I've been drinking vodka. Vodka.
I can't believe she's... What grade was it?
Yeah. What course?
What grade because was she teaching?
Because if it was high school and she had a tight body, then I would have been okay with it.
Yeah, right?
Little
it always goes as to how hot they are. Yeah. As to how bad it is what they
isn't
did.
That's why
all the humans will die eventually is because of that right there.
It was a high school and you're right, Jem.
I mean, everyone will die.
Teachers
the only hope we have is if we just blind everybody.
Here's the thing. Our teachers...
So then everything will be based on smell and how other people smell. And you'll be able to smell when somebody's lying to you because they'll have that fear smell, you know?
Well, here's the thing.
Instead of those big tits and that luscious lips.
Watch the decline.
Yeah, you can still smell big tits.
Our priests fuck little boys and girls.
Oh, yeah.
Boob sweat.
Our pastors are doing drugs and fucking girls. Even rabbis are getting caught for molestation. I know they always were. But
though.
Watch.
Human beings haven't changed.
But here was the thing. Yeah. Well, you know what, though, Jem? There was a
this
time.
This shit is open now.
No, exactly. Let me say this.
It's a lot easier for
me. I get what you're saying.
No. Listen, if you ever listen to like comics and especially when they're drunk or really being open for some reason,
so
maybe they did a little too
comics.
Much mushrooms, right? Or they're actually being sincere on stage. A lot of them have been sexually molested. A lot of them.
I hate that.
They were sexually molested. Their parents or whoever molested them were sexually molested.
I fucking hate
this. This has been going back in generations and generations of human life, okay? And that's just sucks.
Nobody
ever
wanted to even touch me. Like,
so
I
you feel
fucking
bad?
Hate that. Are you kidding me?
Have you never seen yourself in a mirror?
You weren't hot enough for the to rape you when you were 12?
I was a redheaded, cute little kid.
I wasn't sexually molested.
Nobody wanted to touch my dick.
You looked like Opie as a kid. You should have been getting raped every day.
You have no idea how pissed off I am as an adult right now when I hear all the people who have been touched or molested. And like, I really think, did I not show, what did I do wrong?
So the reason why Berger's insecure is because he wasn't raped.
I hate that.
That's not the thing, right? It's like, is it funny or not? We're just saying that stuff to be funny. We're talking about we're talking about molestation. Yeah. Right? So it's the thing about being a comic that I appreciate the most, right? Is that we have the psyche of the world.
Oh yeah.
In our comedy. I mean, we have it. We can damage
people fucking deep, but
if we want to with our comedy, or we can try and save people. But it's a choice you have as a comic.
We can say band damage.
Yeah.
What do you think, Ryan?
Palma?
Well, what?
Go on.
I'm hearing stuff in my head,
yeah, can everyone
too.
Be quiet for a second?
It's off. Oh, what was that?
What was that?
I don't know. I was hearing stuff in my head. I thought I was hearing my phone.
The thing is, I was never sexually molested, but I think I'm... I'm bipolar in a way, and I have my own depression problems, and that's why I use the stage. So,
see, I never get any of that shit.
Yeah.
I never get, you know, bipolar, so you, sometimes you feel up, sometimes you feel down.
Did you see my roller coaster on Facebook? Hey, you
know, I thought that was just a gag. You know who else feels like that?
No, you
is
know
that really what you're doing? What? You know is that really how you're feeling?
Oh, no, yeah, he's a nut. He's a nut job.
Why can't you just start smoking pot and give up drinking?
But no, I keep asking you over and over.
You keep asking everyone.
I do not. I ask guys.
Watch this.
I know Jim's sales are down. He's got to get his sales up.
I would get Ryan high for the rest of his life for free.
Jim, shut up. Because you're a humanitarian.
No, but what I always tell people is, so you feel up sometimes,
yeah,
and then other times you feel kind of
down. Yeah.
You know, they have a name for that besides bipolar. It's called human.
Yeah.
Everybody does. Everyone, Ryan, you know what it is? You're not getting pussy on a regular. No, we are. That's a fact.
That's not.
If you were getting
accurate.
No bullshit, Jim.
That's not.
If you,
accurate.
Ryan, really, tell me right
that's
now. Look accurate. Me in the eye and tell me if you were getting laid constantly. I've would you give a fuck about 90% of the shit?
I'm sorry,
give a
dude.
Fuck
that's
about,
not correct.
Really, so, ask Ryan. Actually, ask Ryan.
Jim, it's true. Every time I fuck a girl, my Facebook posts actually get
always
posted.
Become happy. Yeah.
How
I've
long
seen it.
Though?
Huh? I've seen it.
I don't see why you don't have a girlfriend anyway. You're not fat. I mean, come on. I don't see why you don't
every
have a
girl
girlfriend.
Every girl I've dated, they realize, holy shit, you really do drink a lot. You're kidding. Like, yeah, no fuck. I drink 18 beers in one sitting.
Why?
Yeah,
why?
Jim,
if you weren't molested, I'm just interested.
That's
Jim.
Because
there's no other reason to be upset about life than unless Jim. You were fucked by your father.
Is it 30?
Yeah. There's so many other reasons, Jim.
Yeah. Also,
just seems, I mean, like, that's a good one. But.
I mean, I just think that unless, what's
does
your
that
reason?
Molesting if you
Jim, what's your reason
Jim,
for being so
is
sad?
Is a 30-year-old single man, it's not best to start off a conversation with a woman with, I love Girl Meets World.
Yeah.
Guys,
yeah,
right? I got renewed
that's
for a
not
second
the
season.
Best,
did you like that, though?
Exactly.
Like
that's not the
world?
Best topic of conversation when you're
girl
trying to get laid.
Is
later.
There really a Girl Meets World?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Yeah, it just came.
Cool.
Talmo was super excited about it.
LA is full of women.
It.
There's a lot of women that you can get choose
insane
from, or they can
people.
Choose from
we're
you. And there's a
people.
There's a woman out there that really just you just rock their world.
Well, he'll find her. He'll find
Dr. Jim, thank
I'm
you.
Just saying. I'm just it's obvious.
But until
to me.
He finds her, he's gonna deal. He's gonna be keep fucking.
But did you ever give
ribbon.
It a thought
yeah.
though? Did
yeah.
you
tossing
ever think maybe
back.
To yourself, maybe I should listen to Jim. Maybe
Dr.
I should
Jim.
I don't think
anyone's ever thought that.
Yeah. I honestly don't believe anyone has ever
I'm
thought
so scared
no.
of being
I
on
should
camera
listen
tonight.
To Jim.
I've yeah. learned tonight that Jim is the least cynical person I've ever met.
Right?
In my
no,
life.
He is
no,
a
he
positive
really
guy. Yeah.
Jim
yeah.
is like a really, really yeah. amazingly nice person.
But,
I
try.
But one more time, real mean, quick. Though. Jim, where do you live again?
I live downtown in Skid Row.
Okay. So. Positivity. And so here's the thing.
I have a brand new place that nobody ever lived in before in a building. You know, I get to do a show there once a month. I have comics come in and perform.
Yeah, you should probably talk about that for a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, go for it. Plug
yeah,
your
it's,
shit.
It's called the Star Apartments. We have a show there. Let's see. The first headliner we had PJ Stansbury headlined.
Love PJ.
Jesus Trejo was the feature that night.
Jesus,
he did
a great
amazing
landscaper.
Yeah, did an amazing with his 21 kid joke. Yeah, oh God, wow. that guy's so hilarious. And then we have a show coming up August 27th. Dinah Leffert is going to be
Dinah's
the headliner.
Dinah's great.
Nice.
Yeah, excellent. Yeah.
Last month, our show, we had special guest Laura Crawford. You guys know Laura Crawford, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then the headliner was the Ed and Klee show.
Oh yeah,
no fucking
Klee Wiggins.
Yeah, from Belly Room.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do. That was the first time they'd ever done it outside of the Belly Room.
Wow.
Didn't really transfer that well.
Yeah, I couldn't imagine.
But hey, it was an attempt.
Where is the show and how do people find out about it?
The show is at the Star Apartments, which is 240 East 6th Street, which is where the...
Just show up any day of the week, guys. Just ask for Jim.
So
it's not a big deal.
The show's once a month. It's August 27th is the show, but nobody can come without a special... guest pass. So
nice word.
You gotta have seriously. I mean it's for all the residents of the Skid Row Housing Trust. There's like five buildings or whatever.
That's awesome. Okay.
Yeah,
that's really awesome.
And we put
I'm
it. It's called Feel Better Funnies is the name of the show.
All right.
Like where I live, the reason I live there is because I was I had two operations 9 months apart, emergency, and went into the ER and they had to operate on me. One for my broken foot, then the second time was for my umbilicus hernia. They were nine months apart. And when I had the hernia surgery, I was officially homeless. I'd been homeless like 8 days from being evicted. And because I was on food stamps and I was a veteran, all those things together made me qualify for this program. 3 months later, I moved into the Star Apartments downtown. But I did house it for Leslie for a little while, so I wasn't really there that much.
No, that's cool. This is so much better than us getting to talk about our stuff.
Yeah. I'm actually into it.
When are all of us going to be on that show, by the way?
All of you guys to know in the future you'll be on the podcast Mildly Uncomfortable.
Mildly Uncomfortable.com.
Guys, check it out.
I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to be up in Bakersfield tomorrow night. Jim Trino, a benefit. Check it out, the Nile in Bakersfield.
Yeah.
We have very little time, so I believe I'll speak for Talmo Preston myself. We'll all be at the Hollywood Hotel tomorrow night. And Jen.
PUI.
I forgot.
Don't forget me.
PUI. Okay, we have literally zero time left. PUI, Hollywood Hotel, 10 p.m. tomorrow. We'll all be fucked up.
Closing time, turn all of the lights on over everything.